الملك عبد الله الثاني وفخامة الرئيس عبد الفتاح السيسي وقاد الوفد العراقي دولة رئيس الوزراء مصطفى الكاظمي. إن عقد مثل هذا الاجتماع ومع تواجد التحديات الكبيرة التي تواجهها
challenges that the whole region
على أن القادة السياسيين وقادة الدول الثلاث في حالة تعاون
are usually collaborating on a continuous pace and solidarity base for encountering the challenges and to invest in the opportunities, whether in the field of economy or political or even mutual collaborations. So the leaders confirmed on the continuity of the mutual work in the numerous fields.
منذ عقد اجتماع القمة الثاني والذي انعقد في عمان في الأردن الوفود المشتركة
Our delegations in this period have been gathering whether on bilateral or even tripartite levels and we've managed to create mechanisms of interaction, synergy and work together in economics and we've tackled numerous projects on the mutual and joint base, those kind of ventures that are related to the industrial city. The construction of the industrial city have already come to its final phase. We've also managed to tackle the mutual work on the pharmaceutical and the pesticide manufacturing, in addition to work on the housing and building housing. Those and other topics have also been addressed, and this all comes within the framework of the technical and professional groups, and also within our tripartite we've tackled the important cause and to have the mutual work on the regional and international levels, particularly speaking the Palestinian cause and other numerous files of great significance for the whole region and for the three countries. So one more time, I hereby welcome my colleagues here in Baghdad within their own people and families, so they are most welcomed. And now I call my brother Ayman to have the floor to talk about the leaders' meeting, and thanks everyone. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate, let me just start with thanking you, my dear brother, and I want to say with the name of His Majesty King Jalal Abdel Hussein to pay tribute to our people and leaders of Iraq for the great hospitality and the generous invitation, and for this tripartite summit that gathered His Excellency Abdel Fattah al-Sisi and His Majesty the King and also the Prime Minister. Such a summit that comes to build on what our three countries already launched in terms of the collaboration and integration, and to work on our common interest to get a better future of our peoples and countries. Just like my brother mentioned, our today's summit has already addressed on the global files that could be interpreted into the collaboration in the numerous domains, economically, commercially, politically, etc. And also this is based on three previous summits that reflected the centralization and the commitment of everyone to work on building this Arab collaboration And in this context, we are here one more time in Baghdad to we send a message by our leaders that we are standing side by side to counter our common challenges. And we work in this collaboration from our understanding that we have one common interest and that our security is just linked together and our future is based on what we will be able to achieve based on our collaboration. So we stand by side with our brotherly country, Iraq, which is the message confirmed by His Majesty the King, by himself and by his existence today in Iraq, that we stand by Iraq to confront all of the challenges. As Iraq has been able to get these spectacular victories on the terrorists, which is a victory for all of us, and their absolute sacrifices were really apparent, so we all should work together to stand by side to our brothers of Iraq, because this terrorism is not just a threat to Iraq, but it's threatening all of us. So we all stand side by side to Iraq for the reconstruction, and the stability of their land. And also the message that His Majesty carried out was that we should get Iraq apart from any regional conflicts, in a way that Iraq could be able to continue in their construction and getting what is better for the future of the people. As for the Hashemite Kingdom of Jordan and Egypt and also Iraq, such kind of relation is based, as we said, on a mutual history and a common interest and also common understanding. And we believe that the cooperation between the three countries will contribute profoundly in achieving what's better, not just for our countries and peoples, but also for the whole region. So we will continue and working together by our leaders, His Majesty the King, His Excellency President Sisi, and His Excellency the Prime Minister, all confirm that there should be continuous work on interpreting this leadership, this political leadership, to have tangible results and fruitful results in numerous sectors by which we can work together and we can build upon. And as my brother just said, that the summit has really addressed numerous regional files, on top of which is the Palestinian cause, how to get it essentially resolved. So we all agreed that for lasting peace that we're all pursuing wouldn't be achievable without having an end for this occupation and to meet all of the rights of Palestinian people, one of which is to have their freedom and their independent with a sovereign country based on the 4th of June 1967. We also tackled the Renaissance Dam file, and we are standing side by side to our brothers in Sudan and Egypt in their stance, their rational stance based on the international law, with the importance of coming into consensus without getting filled, without an agreement based on the international law, and that meets and responds to all of the rights of all of the related countries with this dam. Egypt's water security is a part of the integrated Arab security, and we are all supporting Egypt and Sudan, and there was an apparent confirmation on this stance. We also tackled the Syrian file and the importance of gathering all of the efforts to put an end to this conflict. And our leaders confirmed that we should have working on this because it will meet our own also common interest, and there should be a political resolution in a way that can support Syria's sovereignty and independence and put an end to terrorism and put it in a climate that can get the refugees back to their lands. Also, we've tackled the Yemen files and how it's very important to get to a political solution based on the accredited solutions. It also, the summit also reflected the common interest, understanding and conceptions and the will of the leaders in collaborating our work and also their will on the harmonizing and the coordination with our brotherly and neighboring countries to encounter the challenges and to achieve a security and stability for our peoples holistically. So one more time, Your Excellency, and on the name of His Majesty, all appreciation and gratitude to our people in Iraq for the great receival. And again, we support that we will always be at your side, side by side, and work together to help you encountering all of the challenges, and thank you. Thank you so much, Your Excellency. And now, Your Excellency Samah Shukri, the floor is yours. Thank you so much. Actually, His Excellency, the person Fatah al-Sisi, had just assigned me at the beginning to deliver his great and sincere greetings, appreciation to you, Prime Minister, and also to my dear brother, and to His Excellency, the Iraqi leader, for the great organization and hospitality for this summit, this tripartite summit that gathers Iraq, Jordan, and Egypt together. Throughout this summit, we already have tackled, just like you mentioned a while ago, what's been achieved throughout the agreements on our main and common interest, which is promoting our economic capabilities and the solidarity with our Iraqi people to encounter the numerous challenges in this critical essential phase. And this comes out from the one unified destiny of the three countries and our commonwealth to work together with synergy and in a harmonizing way to counter these challenges very effectively, in a way that can also help maintaining our security and our regional Arab security in general. We do have the great will to collaborate with Iraq and with the Hashemite Kingdom of Jordan and to continue working on the outputs of the previous three summits according to the mechanism that we agreed on, and to contribute in all of the activities that will have great impacts on the three countries, people, and help them getting towards sustainable development and progress. And meanwhile, this should also tackle the security files and the files related to the region itself, so we have got the harmonized understanding among the three leaders towards all of those files, as my dear brother Minister Ayman just mentioned. So we look forward also to receive in Cairo the fourth summit, and within the coming phase, and based upon the assignment and the guidance of the leaders, we will get the mechanisms, the ministerial mechanisms, and also the committees to condense their efforts in order to implement the ventures and projects that we agreed on. And unquestionably, on the foreign ministry level, we will continue collaboration and communication in the framework of our discussion, and also with the League of Arab States, to tackle the files and reduce numerous challenges that we all work together, and that how we can encounter them. One more time, I pay tribute to Iraq for this generous invitation, and we do look forward to have a continuous communication along with you and also along with His Excellency Minister Ayman in order to meet and to confirm all of these objectives that we've been assigned to by the leaders, and that we've been assigned also to continue collaboration and to also shed light on the implementation execution framework. Thank you so much.